Checkpoints are frequent on a road from Baghdad into the province of Salahaddin. 5 years ago, it was very dangerous to go here, with frequent robberies and bomb attacks by terrorist groups and criminals. But today, it is better. The driver plays a speech by Saddam Hussein, mostly as a curiosity. Tikrit, in the Sunni-dominated province of Salahaddin, is a former dictator's hometown, and Sunnis here distrust the Shiite-dominated central government, now in power in Baghdad. And that the Shiite-dominated parties under Prime Minister al-Maliki now are in power becomes evident at the entrance to Tikrit. To enter the house that belonged to Saddam's son Oday, and where Saddam was hiding in an underground cavern, is not allowed, forbidden by Maliki. And the gigantic palaces in Tikrit are now controlled by the Iraqi government. Here, curiosity hotels for tourists are planned and the palaces are restored. The 73 palaces were built by Saddam as monuments over himself. His name slate, SH in Arabic, is everywhere. Every wall is covered with expensive Italian marble, and billions of dollars from Iraq's oil wealth was spent on the buildings while the people suffered under the sanctions. The dictator Saddam ruled with an iron fist. Critical voices were mercilessly executed, and the Sunni population, and especially Saddam's own clan, was favored, while hundreds of thousands of Shiites and Kurds were displaced and killed. Underdevelopment is evident today throughout the country, especially in the countryside, which looks the same as 30 years ago. Not much has happened since the country became democratic.
للمحاصيل الزراعية فالريدو أن تنفتح استثمارات أو للقطاع الخاص وينطون دعم أكثر للقطاع الخاص.
But private investments that can develop Iraq are hindered by the central government. The mismanagement is seen in Al Alam, just outside Tikrit. Hardly any goods in the shops are produced in Iraq. Everything is imported, and electricity supply is as bad as it has always been. Foodstuffs melt in the freezers.
والله إن شاء الله التحسن إذا صرنا أقليم وإذا ظلينا على حكومة بغداد ما تعمل شيء.
Armed guards keep watch over the municipal office. Inside there is a meeting. In Al Alam, the people want to have more autonomy and independence from the government in Baghdad. The mistrust is partly because the Sunnis are now degraded from power, but mainly because the Shiite-dominated elected governments have not been able to deliver any progress, despite foreign billions of dollars in aid. After the meeting, Municipal Council Chairman Yassim Al-Yuburi shows the various projects undertaken by them. The municipality is building a new slaughterhouse, but it's not exactly a high-tech project.
شنو اللي مثلا انتج العراق خلال هاي الفتره؟ الجواب لا شيء. بالعكس هي كل الكفاءات كل الخبرات العلميه غادرت البلد بسبب التهجير والعنف الطائفي اللي رافق فتره عام 2006 2007.
The new primary school building is built by hand and work progresses slowly. The municipality receives its budget from the province, who in turn gets the money from the government in Baghdad. The state budget is to 90% financed from the oil. Tax revenues barely exist. But much of the money disappears.
الشعب منتظر خدمات، منتظر أمن، منتظر إعمار، منتظر وظائف حتى نقطع البطالة، منتظر تحسين الكهرباء. فما دام هناك فساد موجود في الوزارات مثل ما نسمع في وسائل الإعلام والصفقات الوهمية والبيع المناصب وغيرها، طبعا هذا يعني يخلق مشكلة وحالة فوضى في البلد والمواطن ما عاد تبقى له ثقة في الحكومة مثلا.
According to Transparency International, Iraq is one of the world's most corrupt countries. But work to uncover corrupt officials is dangerous, especially if those in power have contacts with militias or criminals. That is something the president of the Salahaddin Province Council has experienced.
أنا تعرضت لأكثر من 13 اغتيال بعبوات ناسفة والقنص، وفجرت مكتبي في تصرماتي وحرقت بيتي.
The office of the province was attacked a year ago.
Three suicide bombers, they get from reception, from down, from here, get up, and they come and shot Mr. Niazi office and shot other office here in a hand grenade, and they go up from here, and one of them explosion here, and his hair on the wall, and his leg was here.
Al-Qaeda groups operate in the area and create instability and hinder development. But despite the need, Salahuddin has only received resources to pay 2,000 of the government promise of 11,000 men. So the security forces under control of the province are not sufficient nor effective.
اللجنة الأمنية صحيح قادرة لكن مو ذاك المستوى المطموح. اللجنة بحاجة إلى تدريب، بحاجة إلى معدات وأجهزة تفجيرات وإلى منظومة استخبارات متكاملة.
The American troops had the last few years a good working relationship with the people here, and they trained the Iraqi forces responsible for security. But the Iraqis who were active in this are now threatened. Ahmed worked as an interpreter and wore a mask, but is now sought after on the web by a militant organization.
As we are an Islamic army, we would like to catch this interpreter as soon as possible and cut his head and put him on his back.
A fifth of the population cannot read or write, and nearly half of those of working age are un or underemployed.
لا بعض الشباب ليس لديهم عمل لكن يفترون في الشارع أطباء يعني البنات.
Not even half of the youngsters go on to junior high, and the low education makes labor inefficient, as well as governmental service.
ملينا أعذار الحكومة بالوضع الأمني المتردي. الوضع الأمني الآن جيد بس الوضع الخدمات تعبان. وهي أعذار اتخذها الحكومة بالوضع الأمني.
The crying needs in the community are also reflected in the local authorities, even though they now currently enjoy very luxurious offices in Saddam's old palaces. The Salahuddin province today receives a very scarce amount of the budget from the central government in Baghdad. Under the constitution, they should be given close to 5 billion from state oil revenues, but receives only 200 million.
ولهذا انتفض مجلس المحافظة بطلب تشكيل إقليم لكي تأخذ تخصيصاتها وحصتها المعروفة وفق كثافة سكانية وهي عبارة عن 4.6 من العراق.
There is another 500 million doled out to the province through different projects controlled by the central government. This money cannot be supervised nor controlled by the province, and is another factor that may cause corruption and irritation.
طبعا اذا ما اعطونا صلاحيات وما صار موافق على طلب تشكيل الاقليم هناك اجراءات يعني مثل ما قلت لك نلجا الى المحكمه الاتحاديه ونلجا الى جمع التواقيع يعني الا نوصل لنتيجه يعني.
Another reason for the autonomy demands of the Salahuddin province are the politically motivated arrests done by Prime Minister Maliki's security service. In recent months, thousands of members of other political parties, mostly Sunnis, have been arrested and, according to sources, it is highly likely that they are tortured. This indicates an extremely dangerous tendency of concentration of power to Maliki's Shiite-dominated party. With US troops now out of the country, this serious political sectarian conflict might again escalate into violence in Iraq.
لكن قضية الأقاليم اليوم هي تفرض نفسها علينا أن نذهب بها الاتجاه خوفا من الهيمنة للأحزاب الدينية.